welcome back to Texas Tiger Tavern, the show that demystifies the world of drinking and hopefully helps you branch out to drink something new. I'm your host, Jenny, and today we're talking about a tequila mule and a high noon seltzer. I'm joined with my friend, Molly. Say hi, Molly.
Hi, Molly.
Oh, no. Molly is one of my good friends of many years.
Going on four. We met August.
But this is like the end of the year, really.
We met August 2017.
Yeah, and my head is still in school years, so a year is really, you know, not 365 days for me. Let's get this out the way. Me and Molly are very chaotic together. She just roused me up. Like right now, she's staring at the outline.
I'm trying to make sure we follow it. Guess hellos. I said hello.
We don't need to follow. That's what I was trying to say. Like, mm-hmm. If I ever get lost, this is something to get back to. But like you said, we're just gonna.
And you're not gonna cut this out because it shows the true chaotic energy of all of this.
Of course, so they believe me.
Yes. Okay, so who am I? I'm Molly. How did we meet?
We met. Good old Tiger Band.
Good old Tiger Band. I, of course, played piccolo.
Now we're lying.
And Jenny was in percussion.
I wish.
I like flow of conscious. I started using aluminum-free deodorant this week. And it makes me feel like a wet seal. Not the store, haha, but a wet seal. Almost like a dolphin. And I don't like it, and it doesn't prevent sweat. It does not conceal sweat. It just makes me more moist.
Weren't you just comparing my bar of soap to a dolphin?
But that was on my hand, where I'm just touching it.
Okay.
If it's in my armpit throughout the day, and I was still stinky, so did not work.
And you want this to stay in?
Yes.
Okay.
Because I think people... We'll get to the alcohol. We will get to that. But I think it's important we shoot the shit, show them what our relationship looks like.
Yeah.
Although Jenny tries to conceal her excitement around me, she says that I rile her up and that she is a mellow person, but my energy riles her up.
Yes.
So, but my issue with that is when she's calm, it makes me think, she hates me. So if you ever feel like Jenny hates me on this podcast,
mm-hmm.
It's not true because it's her energy.
I had a grad student that thought I hated her. I disliked her.
Yes.
But I didn't hate her.
I didn't
hate anybody.
I think you show your emotions more than you.
More than I think.
Yes.
But the thing is, this is what I say. This is what I say to people. I'm an only child, and I just feel like I know when to just shut down.
That's called trauma. That is called issues that we need to work through.
Yeah.
Here's some background on me. I'm glad you mentioned trauma. I am one of six, so... Even if I shut down, there was always someone prodding. So that is why I prod you when you shut down, because I go...
You think of yourself as an older sister?
No, not older, younger. We all did it. But I think, well, I'm not going to let her sulk. Let's move through this. Let's move through it. Are we going to take a sip of this for them to...
I'm waiting, you know, you wanted to...
I just feel like... You know, like our personalities, that's a cocktail in of itself. All right, let's take our sip. What did we put in this? Tell them, what did we put in this?
First drink we're gonna do is a tequila mule, which is basically a Moscow mule, just instead of vodka with tequila. So we use the simple version, which is ginger beer.
It's like a lemon lime.
Lemon lime sweetened juice from this convenience store or whatever.
Yes.
Do you go to Rouse's?
No, I went to Mathern's.
Mathern's. Rouse's has it too.
Form of lemon lime.
And a tequila.
And which tequila did we use?
Casamigos.
Because we are the Real Housewives. I said Beverly Hills before. They don't drink that. They drink Whispering Angel Rosé.
Mm.
Orange County Housewives drink Casamigos. You know who loves Casamigos? Denise Richards. And I'm telling you that. That is a for a fact. She drinks it straight dry.
As she should. It's that good.
And
people love it.
They do. But we're not at, I'm not at that point. You're probably at that point. I can't really just sip on it.
Yeah. So. But we're going to take our first sip. Or I'm going to take my first sip, yes, if we're going to be honest. Because Molly's going to be the person to be like, you're lying.
I didn't say that. Don't put words in my mouth. Don't do that. I set my boundaries. Please don't do that.
Can we clean?
Oh, yeah. I'm going to spill. Okay, okay.
First sip of the podcast for me.
Oh. I think it's good. You did well.
This is good. This is...
Is it not your usual palate?
I just don't like ginger.
You can barely taste it.
No, my head tastes it. I know. When I was sick, just...
Well, it's good for you. It's great for your sinuses. I'm just saying, I love rum.
I didn't know that.
I'm not, like, saying I know anything about rum.
But you prefer.
I like Bacardi, mm-hmm, and of course, I like Malibu. These are not
they're
like...
basically the same thing.
No. Malibu is coconut flavored.
Okay.
I'm just saying, they taste very different.
I've just never had it in my life.
You've never had Malibu?
No.
You've never been a drunk sorority girl?
Not yet.
There's always time.
So the Tequila Mule.
What do you think?
As I said before, or if, I don't remember if I said it.
Ginger.
Not a fan of ginger, but I am going to make, I have a Moscow Mule episode where I make a simple Moscow Mule and do extra for a out-of-pocket Moscow Mule.
What so is I'll an out-of-pocket?
I'll make ginger syrup.
That seems unnecessary.
But this is my, this is, the podcast is literally about drinking, about cocktails and drinking. So it's like, why not? What do I lose?
You don't lose anything, I guess.
Yeah, you just bought lime juice.
Yeah, because it was also mixed in with the simple syrup. I didn't know what you have. Jenny didn't prepare me. She said, bring your favorite drink. She didn't say, these are the things I have.
Because honestly, I thought it would be some type of wine.
I don't really like wine. Mm. I only drink wine when it's easy for me to drink wine. Yeah. I don't go to a restaurant and I'm like, let me get a Pinot Grigio. I just want, if I'm going to a restaurant, I want them to make me something with liquor so that I actually get drunk. So that's, I like the tequila. It's refreshing.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't make me feel super bloated after.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas if I were to like, and again, I'm not well versed in this world, you know? So if I can't do like, no, this is going to sound so like unknowing. Like I don't do like Jack and Coke. That makes you feel bloated. But I do like that, but it makes you feel bloated afterwards. And mm-hmm, it's a lot of calories. And this is also, you know, calories, but it's clear, so it makes me feel better. Jenny's a little drunk right now.
Because no.
She's a lightweight. We all know this. Lightweight! She had a hard seltzer, and we know that knocks the girl down. And when I came in, she wouldn't answer her phone for an hour and a half. I'm ringing the doorbell. Ring, ring, ring.
I don't even have a doorbell.
I'm ringing the doorbell. And I finally just bust in because I've been lifting, so my legs are crazy strong. Quads, so big. And I bust in the door, and I see her on the floor. And I said, this girl must have had a White Claw. Someone call the police, because Jenny got her hands on a White Claw. And we cleaned her up, and I said, you know, be professional. You booked me. We're going to get this over with. And 3 hours later, here we are. Do you feel sober enough, Jenny?
Let me ask you. Is this your podcast?
No, but you know.
I mean, you just did a whole little skit just now.
Do we want to reveal what you told me before the podcast? Are we going to reveal the movie?
Yeah, because I don't remember.
Movie magic? Again, wasted. Me talking a lot. You know, it's putting me in the front runner. I know we've heard Philip. No, love the guy. But,
have you heard Philip? Because you haven't been listening to the episodes.
Listen, I am a very busy woman, and job's very high stakes. On the phone with clients constantly. China wants China wants it now. And we can't get it to China for 3 to 5 business days. And it's just that all day long. All day long. What were you gonna say? So me and Jenny are both marketing people.
Yes.
Jenny has gotten her first big girl job, correct?
It's basically a 2-month trial right now.
Which, that's good.
Yeah, it's
good. Options open for everyone.
Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
That's pretty good, babe.
Yeah, it is.
That's real good. I like that a lot.
But we never finished how we know each other.
Oh, yeah. We both played tuba. Yes, we us ladies played tuba in band. Marching band, to be exact. You know, the kind where you're active.
The golden band from Tigerland.
The golden band from hell. What? I didn't say that. She didn't say that. Who said that? Jenny.
There's only 2 people in this
Jenny,
room.
Jenny, why would you say that?
There's only 2 people in this room.
I will say, I got such a good farmer's tan from that experience.
Yeah, no. This whole year, I've been thinking about my tan.
Yeah, it's never gonna get it. Literally, it's always slightly off.
I'm always just a little darker.
Yes.
And that, the lightness has just been like, oh, wow. Because we've been doing band since high school.
We haven't. We stopped 3 years ago.
I know, but like, you gotta think, that tan, that marching band tan.
Yeah, no, I agree.
And then for us to stop.
Do you wanna know what actually happened to me though? The summer after marching band, I got a camp job. Mm-hmm. And no, I went to the beach in Florida and it was for my friend's mom's birthday. I'm like Celtic. Actually, I have a lot of Spanish descent, but I got blessed with all the fair skin genes. So we talked about this the other day. Anyways, I burn really easy. The tan is gradual for me. I am as white as you can get. Sorry, Jenny's not paying attention. She's reading a text, and it distracted me. Anyways, I went to the beach, and I had to sit out there for about 5 to 7 hours, I believe. I was sober, and I was young, and then the next day, I was basically third-degree burn, and my skin peeled off like a chemical peel, and I will say that helped the process. Literally, my chest skin, it actually cleared up a lot of my acne that I also got from band. So anyone who is struggling, don't go pay for that pesky chemical peel. Go to the beach. Anyways, so let's talk alcohol, because that's what this is about, right?
Exactly. Sorry. How's the taste for you? Why is this your favorite drink?
I said refreshing.
Oh, yeah.
And
I will say this is
not bloating. Ginger, it is an anti-inflammatory, so
that still doesn't sway me.
Okay.
But I also, while I was doing research, they were talking about how you definitely should use ginger beer instead of ginger ale because there's less ginger
in a ginger ale. That's just sugar and carbonated water.
Yeah.
That's a Sprite.
I love some Sprite.
I do too. I feel like you could probably make a mule with a Sprite. It'd just be Sprite and tequila.
Yeah.
That's another good drink that I would go for. What was your go-to at, you know, Tigerland back in the day? What did you get?
Vodka Sprite, maybe? I don't know. Genuinely, I don't know if it's just because I'm too pretty, but I only remember one time being
drunk
at the bar buying something.
I never did that. That's, I would get water, but I was too young. I did buy Mike's 190 later on.
Oh, yeah.
That's different.
Motorcycle. Well, by the time I went to Fred's, I was 21.
Let's talk about Fred's, yeah? Are we allowed to talk about local bars? Are they gonna disband this podcast if they hear of it? Okay.
If they ever sponsor me, then I have to, like,
delete this episode.
Delete the whole thing.
So Fred's, I went to the first time my junior year. And I think that's a proper time to go because it's old ass people. But it is old people and it's not like they're cuter than everyone else at Tigerland, but it's still not good. And for me, I struggle with looking a little bit underage. Do you feel this?
Yeah.
I think on my best day, I can look 21.
Yeah.
But, you know, if I dress the way I dress, sometimes I do look a little younger.
Yeah.
And it wasn't fun, and no one wanted to buy me drinks at Fritz. So, really, I'm just like, actually, no, I did get a White Claw from a guy, but, what's a White Claw? Oh, it's a Jenny, it's a lot! Yay! She's dancing out to the live band. I'm coming out of my cage, and Jenny's up in the front row trying to crowd her. And she throws up on the main singer, and then, you know, kicked out of the bar. It's like always.
It's a whole thing.
So, what we're trying to say is Jenny's go-to was a White Claw. I remember one time we were at Mike's, and that was the first time we got, like, tequila shots. And I think, honestly, that was probably the first time I had tequila. Or, like, realized I had tequila, because it was straight.
Yeah.
And I really, that started the love with me. I'm being serious. That's not
Mike's? Serious. Your connection is going to be Mike's?
Wait, it wasn't Mike's. That was Fred's. No, hold on.
What year was it?
No, that was Fred's.
Oh, thank goodness.
Because that was a luau. No.
No, Mike's.
No, it wasn't luau then. It was the one time I didn't wear that red skirt to luau, and I wore it to Boats and Hoes.
We didn't have Boats and Hoes at first.
What was it? I wore the luau skirt for some reason, and it wasn't luau.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. But we did not have Boats and
Hoes. But it was Fred's. We were at Fred's.
Yeah. Better than Mike's.
I don't agree. I
have an association.
I had a lot of good times at Mike's. Flirted with
the bouncer.
A bouncer.
Yeah.
I also like to request songs that were never played. That was fun.
Oh yeah, we'd stay by the DJ stand.
We'd stay. We were embarrassing. We did get on the. I got on the speakers quite often. Philip got on the speakers though. I never got on the big middle speaker. Let's just point that out. I wasn't that person.
Yeah, that's a different
person. I was in the corner looking at the crowd on the speaker. They were twerking. Let's just call it what it was.
Having a whole whop.
Having a Cardi B, Megan Thee Stallion Grammy performance on the speakers. Did they look as good? No.
No. I mean, I saw it on TikTok before.
What
I saw it on.
What TikTok are you on?
A different side than you.
Yeah, apparently so. I am on the Christian side. I'm on the Lord's side. No, but. I will say that it was not executed well, that little leg twist. You could tell it was a little, what's happening here?
It was aggressive.
Anyways, don't know what I need to say. Wait, hold on. The reason I said that is because I've been thinking it for 3 days now and I haven't said it to anyone. So I had to get it out.
I'm glad you got it out.
Let's move on.
Moscow Mule, tasting notes,
tequila
ginger.
Mule, sorry.
Do you taste the tequila?
No, not really.
No, I think the ginger is very overpowered.
It overtook it a little.
Yeah, and we shared half a can.
Yeah.
But that's why they use crushed...
Did you only use one?
Yeah.
One of the tequilas?
So you only put one ounce? I used both tequilas.
Oh, okay. So we both had 2 ounces of tequila each, and it's not hitting, really.
2 ounces of tequila, I did a quarter ounce of the lemon juice... sweetener.
The it was not filled to the rim, so we didn't overflow.
And the thing is, they use crushed ice in Moscow Mules and Tequila Mules because it's a volume, and so they might use the same amount of liquid, but we can't tell because it's crushed ice and it takes up a lot of space.
Yeah,
which is the most thing.
I think we
could have
gone lighter on the ginger beer,
maybe,
and maybe less ice, but we were working with some warm materials.
We were sitting here for 15 minutes.
I got nervous.
Molly did, but she's...
Are we still going to do the high noons?
Yeah. Back to the podcast.
Oh, what? We were away?
We were away.
That's editing magic. Can we make this, like, call her daddy?
This is...
What the f... Is that... I've been listening a lot.
I know you have, you told me.
I know. Okay, keep going. Back to the podcast.
This podcast is probably the first one that's less about the alcohol.
Isn't that what we want, people?
Well, we'll see.
This Come will, to daddy.
This will be A/B testing.
Oh, we love that in marketing.
Yeah. So, don't open that yet.
Oh. Maybe it is hitting. This one is gonna make us drunk. I want you to know. Have you had one before?
No. Have you had one before?
No, I've heard reviews. And it will.
It's only 4.5.
I've heard
that's less than a White Claw.
Okay, I've heard that it gets you there.
Okay, listen.
It's vodka.
Ma'am, can shush.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I really need to be quiet.
I'm sorry.
Per interviews, we usually have one drink that the interviewee loves or drinks the most, and they bring it and introduce it to me. And one thing that I'll do is buy something or make something that they're new to both of us, or they just wanted to try before. And we're gonna try the High Noon Sun Sips. Now, I did some research on this one while I was waiting. This seems a little suspicious to me.
Why?
They have nothing on YouTube, like, from their brand. It's very simple.
Though.
It's everywhere, but it's like, they're not marketing for this.
So this is the equivalent to the COVID vaccine. We will break out in hives and possibly die after this.
But there are a lot of people doing reviews about it because all the seltzers do. Yeah. But I got something for you. Fun fact, High Noon is made by Gallo Wine.
I don't know anything about Gallo Wine.
They're a wine company, obviously. Big wine, they're in the cheaper end of things.
Okay.
They own New Amsterdam as well, and other subsidiaries. But this is special. This is getting all the rave because this is actually made with vodka.
Yeah.
Whereas White Claws and other seltzers are made with malt liquor.
And what is it? Malt liquor is much cheaper, correct? It's lower in value. Lower in value, but lower in quality.
Yes, it's basically distilled sugar.
Yes.
And
it gives you bad hangovers.
Yeah, it's on the side of, when you think malt liquor, you think of a beer, you think of a 40-ounce Colt 45.
Uh-huh.
That's what those things are in. So
their
whole
vodka
branding is on vodka.
And I can appreciate that. Because also, I don't need a mixture of alcohols in one drink. I don't know if that's what is in a White Claw.
It's not.
You don't think they mix multiple?
It's just malt liquor seltzer, yeah.
No, never mind.
But ingredients in this say, we got the peach flavor. I got this at our local liquor store, which we're trying to get sponsored. We're trying to get sponsored, Molly. So.
Wait, the one on the corner of Nicholson? That's the famous one with the good po' boys.
Oh, no.
Subs.
No, Caroline's dad. Caroline told me her dad used to stop there.
Everyone loves that place.
I've never been in my life.
World renowned.
Never heard anything.
It's like a spicy Italian sandwich.
Wow. Well, you're in here first. But anyway, we're trying to get sponsored by BenQ.
I don't know where that is.
It's on Perkins.
You drive to Perkins?
Yeah, I do.
Is that a lie for the sponsor?
No, I'm dead ass. I've been there twice already to get shit for the podcast.
That seems like very out of the way for no reason.
No, it's
Perkins from here.
Not even down, not past College Walmart. It's closer. It's closer to Trader Joe's.
Okay. Okay. I believe you. I believe you this time.
You know, I'm cutting that whole thing out. Just drink the drink.
No. I want to hear it. No, go redo it. Redo it so that you get your sponsorship.
I'm trying to get sponsored by BenQ.
Oh, the one on Perkins?
Yes. I've been there twice already to get things for the podcast, drinks, alcoholic drinks, and mixers. And the workers there have been really helpful.
Aww.
And so I'm trying to slip in that every time I go, I say that I have a podcast. So if like multiple people go in and be like, oh, I heard this off of James podcast.
I can do that for you. I can do that.
We're trying to get sponsored by our local
store. Do they have an Instagram?
Yeah, they do.
I can literally tag them and be like, OMG, heard about this? Okay, well.
Got it from High Noon. Got it from BenQ.
Did you get it from there?
Yes.
Look at you go. And, okay, cool. I'll say, wow. Wow. I heard, you gotta listen to this podcast. Have you heard of her? Jenny Myers. And
what's the name of the podcast, Molly?
Texas Tavern.
No.
Texas Tavern Talk.
No.
Tavern Talk.
Tavern Talk.
I thought that was already used. That's why I didn't guess it. It's a good one.
Yeah.
I just thought it would have been used already. Anyways.
No fructose corn syrup. No artificial flavors. 2.3 grams sugar. Best served cold.
Okay. You don't always trust that, though, because they get you. Oh, it is gluten-free. 100 calories. I mean, that's fine.
Modesto, California.
Okay, yeah.
We got the peach flavor.
American made.
We got the peach flavor made with real juice, vodka. Stop it. Made with vodka with real fruit juice, sparkling water, and natural flavors.
All right, are we ready? Are we gonna?
Yes, because you're impatient.
Well, we've been talking about it, and I've been looking at it for 10 minutes. 30.
Cheers.
Oh. Oh.
No.
It's really not good.
No, this is a no for me.
Yeah, this is not, I mean, peach really isn't my thing, to be honest, but it's not bad. It just kind of tastes like Gerber Baby, like food.
When's the last time you had Gerber Baby food?
Nice afternoon snack. Just like a high noon.
No, we're bashing high noon. We don't like it.
We hate it. No, I do not taste the alcohol.
No, but vodka is,
No, I don't agree. I usually taste vodka in anything it's in.
But, really?
Yes.
Really?
I do think vodka is like...
I think of vodka as a very... High noon's all hype.
Well, I think probably this White Claw is how many? How much percent alcohol?
I thought it was 5.
Okay, sure. Well, listen, I'll tell you. Two of my buddies told me that they got drunk off their booties on this, so I thought
drinking one or all four,
probably two each.
Mm-hmm.
You know, also I'm a slow drinker, especially, let me tell you this, I'm not a big seltzer fan because the gas is too much for me, the bubbles, I don't need all that.
No, I agree,
it just causes discomfort, and when you're drinking you're already bloated, splits you any even more, and you know when I'm drinking I'm trying to look cute and this doesn't make me look cute, and then guess what, you're holding in farts the whole night. Like, honestly, it's a no for me.
This is a big no for me. I think this might be the first no of the podcast.
How many stars out of 5 would you give it? How many sips out of 5 would you give it? How many sips would you take of this before you said it's not worth my time?
The first sip for both of us was like,
yeah,
wow.
But
nah.
If I had to choose between this and a beer, I would drink this.
I'd drink a beer. I'm getting more into beer, for sure.
Tastes like weed. Don't like it.
It is weed tea.
Yes.
This tastes... It tastes like a smell.
Well,
does that make sense?
You got peach. Yeah, it's not like flavorful enough to be anything. It's like a hint of a scent. No, it's like a hint of a sense. Like, it's not even like... It's not a full flavor.
Yeah.
It's not a robust flavor, let's say that.
Yeah, there's no real, like, if I were to put this in a cup, you not smell it, you wouldn't get peach.
And what do you pair this with? I would maybe eat this with barbecue, I'm not even joking, but other than that...
No, I agree. This is, it's a still like a summertime drink, but it's so much, it's not refreshing.
No, it isn't.
Because there's no flavor for
me. If I were to go to the beach and it's 100 degrees outside and I can't crack this open, I'd probably pass out. This is bad.
Yeah. I paid $9.99 for 4.
Dude, do you know how much it was at Mathurin's for 8?
$17.99.
That's pretty bad.
Yeah.
That's pretty absurd.
Yeah, I'm glad. If I try something new, I try to get it in the single and pay whatever rather than getting... Because now I have 2 more. I might trade it for something else, but...
They don't go bad, really.
Yeah, there are seltzers. Seltzers are taking the market. You know, they're stealing... Not stealing customers, but from the beers. From the beer drinkers.
Well, usually girls would do the beer just to be able to... You know, it's easy. It's polite. It's, oh, y'all have beer, I'll drink it. But now the guys are a little bit like, I'll go for a seltzer. So then now it's pleasing. Everyone's got it.
Yeah.
Everyone's got it. Frat parties, they had beer and seltzers.
We'll never choose
a
seltzer.
Okay, not frat party. Who am I kidding? I never went to a frat party. What the frick? Oh, I said frick!
Okay.
I'm at the frat tailgates. Go on.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to talk about this. Everyone listen up. So, my friends visited Austin a couple weeks ago. I did not go. They came back and they were raving, okay?
Yeah, it's like the LA of the South.
Yeah, and then I saw a TikTok today where the girl was like, moving to Austin just because you wanted to is not a personality trait. I'll send it to you.
Yeah.
And I just wanted to know what your take on that was.
People moving to Austin?
Yeah. and like turn it. Joe Rogan's there. All the comedy's moving there. It's about to get real.
Companies are moving there, you know, more towards Dallas. It's, there's a lot of space, but it's also like,
y'all are about to
the more people that move and deplete the characteristics.
Yeah, the culture.
The culture of it, it dilutes the whole thing for everyone.
Well, that's what I'm saying. It's such a boom that I'm like, oh, 10 years is, it's gonna be dead.
No, but that's why I'm thinking more of Dallas.
I like Dallas. Y'all were telling me Dallas was
Dallas is more corporate and douchey, though.
Yeah, but, you know, if everyone moves there.
Yeah.
Might get some cool art scene.
We're all here thinking about staying in Baton Rouge, so...
I'm not thinking about that in any way. That's you.
Yeah.
That's foolish of you. It's an expensive city with no payoff.
Baton Rouge?
Yes. Compared to other cities you can move to. Baton Rouge is comparable, but you don't get the payoff of it. So, Jenny, how do you rate Hainan?
1 out of 10.
1 out of 10 taste.
I'd give it a 3.
Okay, taste?
Out of taste.
Yeah, I'd agree with a 3.
Probability of buying again, 1 out of 10. I would never buy again.
It literally, I'm like, I don't really buy White Claws or Trulies. I might buy this to be a little cuter, but that's it. Like, be like, yeah.
Just because of the pack?
Yeah, I'm like, I'm different. It's a High Noon, not a White Claw. But I don't, yeah.
How much are White Claws at the bar?
I don't know. I don't know.
Yeah.
Anyways, so
is there
overall,
anything you liked about it, though?
Not really. I like that it's in a can.
Seltzers. No more seltzers.
They're not good.
They're all the same, and one's just either worse than the other. Nothing is... No seltzer is better than the other. One, it could just be worse than the other.
And maybe one day we'll find that, but we have not found it yet.
Today's... Season 1 is not the season.
Not the season.
Anything else you want to say about the alcoholic world, Molly?
I'll say the tequila meal. That's it.
It was good.
It wasn't.
And I think that after I got over the ginger smell in my nose, it started to be good, refreshing. But this High Noon, I would not recommend, y'all. But if you have an argumentative comment about it, go for it. Sway me.
Comment down below.
This podcast was definitely different than the others have been. Molly is way more pop culture, and depending on what I keep in, it's gonna be less about the drinks and more about Molly and her improv.
Redo that. You didn't talk at all about my improv, and you're not about to label me.
You just talked about me on the floor drunk.
Yeah, that's called me being funny. We don't have to label it as improv. Just let me be funny. We don't need to downgrade it to
okay,
that.
Okay, do a...
Restart it. Go again. Take 2. Action.
Segue us out, Molly.
Am I reading this?
No, just give us a summary of what happened this
past. As always, if you're on the Anchor app, you can leave a message or a question. We really appreciate it. We want your feedback. We want it. We appreciate it. If not, make sure to follow us on Instagram at TX Tavern Talk. That is TX Tavern Talk. If you see a video of drinks we have made, what? What does that say?
If you haven't already... If you haven't already, follow us on Instagram.
Yeah, I said that. Anyway. Okay, well, I'm going to skip this part. Thanks for listening. Thanks for listening to Tavern Talk with our drink of the day, the Tequila Mule and the pitiful High Noon. Watch out for our next episode where you will be talking about what, Jenny?
I don't know. I'm thrown for a loop.
We'll see. Stay tuned.
Where Molly won't be here.
Ta-ta.
To die.